So welcome students. So in this question, say you're given that you have a triangle whose vertices are x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. And you're asked to find the equations of the median AD and the line through A parallel to BC and the angle bisector of A using determinants. So you're given some expressions, determinants, you're asked to show that the equations of these lines are so and so. So let us try to find the equations of each line using the method of determinants. So first, so if you want to find the equation of the median AD, so how do I do this? So assume that you have a triangle. So that you have a triangle, this is the midpoint, and you have the median AD. So this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2, this is x3, y3. Assume that these are the 3 points. So now what is the condition which each and every point on this median satisfies? So if P is any point on this median, so we know that if you join P with B, so if you join P with B and P with C, we know that the median divides the triangle into two equal halves, and so this triangle area is equal to this triangle area. And also if you take the triangle PBC, for this also PD is the median, hence this area is equal to this area. So this total area ABD is equal to ADC, these two areas are same and these two areas are also same. Hence the remaining area as this area is same as this area. So area of this triangle is exactly same as area of this triangle. So now this implies, what is the formula for area of the triangle? Determinant of this point is x, y1. So let us go in some particular direction. If you want to go in clockwise direction, you can go in clockwise direction. If you go in anti-clockwise direction, you can go in anti-clockwise direction. So if you want the numbers to be of the same sense, you have to go in the same direction in both cases. So now let me go in the counterclockwise direction. So x1 y1 1 and x2 y2 1. So this represents the area of this triangle. This number might be either positive or negative, and we have gone in anti-clockwise direction, that's one thing. Plus, and if this area is equal to this area, so this area plus, so I'll go in counterclockwise in the first triangle and I'll go in clockwise in the next triangle. So if I go in clockwise in the next triangle, so this number, if it is positive, this number will be negative. If this number is positive, this number will be negative, and the sum of them will be equal to 0. So for one triangle I have gone in counterclockwise direction, for the other triangle I'll go in clockwise direction. So x1 y1 1 and x3 y3 1 is equal to 0. So this will be the condition which every point on this median satisfies. So this will be the equation of the triangle. So in one case I have gone in counterclockwise direction, so this and clockwise direction, these two will have equal magnitudes but opposite signs, hence the sum of these will be equal to 0, hence that is the equation of the median AD. So now in the second case, if I want the equation of a line through A parallel to BC, so how do I do this? Assume that you have a triangle ABC and you have a line parallel to BC. So now if you take any point P on this, you take any point P on this line, so what is the condition that P satisfies? Can you see that area of triangle, if you join APB, join APB and APC, APB and APC are having the same base and having their vertices on the same parallel. So these two triangles, APB and APC, are two triangles on a common base having the vertices on the between the same parallels, hence these two triangles have equal areas. These two triangles have equal areas. So if I take the determinants in opposite directions, the sum will be equal to 0. If I take the determinants in the same direction, then one determinant will be equal to the other determinant. So what is the equation of this? So if this is x comma y, this is x2 y2, and this is x3 y3, this is x1 y1. So now what is the area of triangle APB? So let us go in counterclockwise direction. So the area is x y1, x1 y1 1, x2 y2 1. So this will be equal to, if I want to write in the form of equal to, in the second triangle also I will have to go in the same direction. So I will have to go in the same direction. Now for this triangle also I will go in the same direction, counterclockwise direction, is equal to determinant of x y 1, x 1 y 1 1, x 3 y 3 1. So this will be the equation of the line parallel to BC through A. So this is the condition which it satisfies. So now let us go to the third question. So now the third question is about the equation of angle bisector AD. So if A is the vertex, if you draw the angle bisector AD of this angle A, we know that the angle bisector always divides the opposite side in the ratio of adjacent sides. That is, BD is to DC is equal to C is to D. BD is to DC is equal to adjacent sides, ratio of adjacent sides. Now, what is the theory? Area of triangle ABD, triangle ABD divided by triangle ADC is nothing but C by B. Area of this triangle is to area of this triangle is C is to B, because these two triangles have same heights. The bases are in the ratio C is to B, hence the areas are also in the ratio C is to B. Now, if you take these small triangles, these two triangles also have the same height, and the bases are in the ratio C is to B. So, triangle BPD by triangle CPD is also in the ratio C is to B. Now, if you subtract this from this and this from this, so those will also be in the ratio B is to C. So, these two triangles are in the ratio C is to B, these two triangles are also in the ratio C is to B. Hence, the difference is big triangle minus small triangle is this, big triangle minus small triangle is this. So, these two triangles are also in the ratio C is to B, is triangle APB, area of triangle APB, APB by area of triangle APC is also in the ratio C is to B. This implies B times, what is the area of triangle APB? APB. So, let us go in any particular direction. So, let us go in counterclockwise direction. That is x, y, 1, x, 1, y, 1, 1, x, 2, y, 2, 1 is equal to B times this area is equal to C times triangle APC. So, what is the area of triangle APC? Here also you have to go in counterclockwise direction if you want the same signs. So, here also you have to go in this direction, that is x, y, 1, x, 3, y, 3, 1, and x, 1, y, 1, 1. So, now if you go, if you take both of them onto this direction, so you get B times this determinant minus C times this determinant is equal to 0. So, if you want to make this minus as positive, you can exchange two rows in this determinant. So, I will make this positive, and I will write x, y, 1, x, 1, y, 1, 1, x, 3, y, 3, 1. Similarly, B times x, y, 1, x, 1, y, 1, 1, x, 2, y, 2 is equal to 0 is the equation of the angle bisector. Thank you.